This is Jeffrey Drazen for the New England Journal of Medicine.
Approximately half of patients with asthma have mild disease. Of these patients, some are treated with short-acting beta agonists, which we call SABAs, only when they have asthma symptoms, while others are treated with inhaled glucocorticoids, which we call ICS, every day without regard to asthma symptoms. Is there another approach to treatment of these patients? The Sigma 1 trial was designed to compare the number of well-controlled asthma weeks, a composite measure of asthma burden, among various regimens used to treat mild asthma. The trial enrolled just under 4,000 patients with mild asthma who were randomized to one of three inhaled treatment arms: twice daily placebo plus as-needed SABA, which we call as-needed SABA, twice daily placebo plus as-needed ICS, and a long-acting beta agonist in a single inhaler, which we call as-needed combination, or twice daily ICS plus an as-needed SABA, which we call ICS maintenance. After a year of treatment, the percentage of well-controlled asthma weeks was 34.4% for as-needed combination, as compared with 31.1% for as-needed SABA and 44.4% for ICS maintenance. The as-needed combination was superior to as-needed SABA, but inferior to ICS maintenance. The rate of severe exacerbations was 0.07 per year with as-needed combination, as compared with 0.09 per year with ICS maintenance and 0.20 per year with as-needed SABA. Patients on as-needed combination used only one-fifth of the median dose of inhaled glucocorticoids as ICS maintenance.
ICS maintenance gives better asthma control, but is no better at preventing severe exacerbations than as-needed combination, which has less ICS exposure. Full study results are available at NEJM.org.